Hello, everyone. My name is Angela Watson, and I am the principal of Bridgewater Raynham Regional High School. This will be my 21st year in the district, and every year gets better, even this year. Unfortunately, our orientation is going to be a little different this year. As you know, this is our new normal that we're dealing with. So this year, first time ever, we're hosting a virtual orientation. I'm here to welcome you and kick it off. And as I do each year, I always feel it's very important to share with you our core values. These are the things that drive the decisions that we make here at BR. So at BR, our core values and beliefs about student learning drive what we do each and every day. They drive every decision that we make. We have four core values: building readiness, building respect, building resiliency, and building relationships. First core value is building readiness. This is preparing you for the real world. It's preparing you for all that is to come, and it's teaching you how to navigate through those kind of uncertain and uncomfortable times. This could be with social issues, but it could also be with your academic issues as well. Our second core value is building respect. This is really at the core of everything that we do, first and foremost, even before academics. Everyone and everything deserves our respect. Every student, every staff member, every parent that enters our doors, everyone here deserves a safe and welcoming environment, and we don't tolerate disrespect. Our third core value is building resilience. It's our job to help you develop those skills, those social emotional skills, those perseverance skills. You have to be able to overcome obstacles. We're not about letting you stick your head in the sand and hoping it's going to go away. It's learning that things don't always go your way. So now what do we do? You know, this is a tough skill, not just for students, but also for adults, but it's a really important skill, especially now. Our last core value is building relationships. We feel that education is a shared responsibility between parents, the school, students, and our community. We encourage you to be active participants and communicate with us. If there is a problem, please don't let that build on your end. Please reach out with any questions or concerns that you have. So at the high school, as I mentioned earlier, I'm Angela Watson, the building principal. We have three assistant principals. Yolanda Beach is one of our assistant principals. Mr. Rob Ringette is another assistant principal. And Mr. Tom Bresnahan is our third assistant principal. You can reach all of us anytime. That is our phone number here at the school, 508-697-6902. Email is honestly the best method of communication. We're on our email constantly. So please feel free to reach out with any questions or concerns. So again, I'd like to welcome you to BR. This year is going to be challenging, yes. It's also going to be very exciting. So you're going to be listening to a lot of different presenters tonight, staff, students, administrators. I encourage you to listen, go back, replay these videos again, take it all in, and just pack your flexibility. Because again, this year will be like no other. And as long as we're patient, we're flexible, and we work together, we will get through this. I welcome you back to the 2021 school year. Enjoy.
Thank you. So let's get into our new normal. Students and staff must wear a face mask throughout the school day. Also, students must wear a mask on the school bus, arrival to school, and how that works. We'll also get into lunch and the way that's different this year, one-way hallways and one-way stairwells, as well as the schedule and how the blocks will operate, even the use of the water fountain, as well as when you can use the bathroom, and finally, how dismissal will work. Students can enter the building at 7:17 a.m. For students who come on the school bus, students must stay on the bus until 7:17. For those who drive in or they're going to be dropped off, all drop-offs and drivers must stay in the vehicle. At 7:17, everyone comes in. For students arriving on the Rainham side where those buses drop off, there are two entrances. For those who already have their lunch, they bring it from home. They will go through the doors on the left. For those who need to get lunch from the cafeteria, they will go off to the right and into the cafeteria. Students can pick up their lunch in the morning when they arrive, and students have until 10:44 a.m. to go by the cafeteria to buy their bagged lunch. There are markers on the floor for social distancing.
Hey, we're for Rainham. We want to grab some lunch. Follow me.
Uh-huh. Hey. What's up, guys?
It's 7:17, time for school.
There is no advisory this school year, so for those students who need to go to the cafeteria to get lunch when they arrive, they can go right ahead, and after that, they can go right to first period. All students go right to first period and have all seven periods every day, no rotation this year in the schedule, and no classes drop. The first day of school is Wednesday, September 16th. On that Wednesday, Cohort A and C come to school while Cohort B logs in from home into Google Classroom. And on Thursday, the 17th, Cohort B and C come to school while Cohort A is at home logging into Google Classroom. And finally, on Friday, the 18th, Cohort C, sub-separate and SEL students only, come to school while Cohorts A and B and the rest of C log on to Google Classroom. And that's just for the first week of school. This year, we are doing one-way hallways and one-way stairwells in accordance with state guidelines. Please note that an email of slides with a map for every floor and arrows showing the direction has been emailed to all parents and guardians from the principal. and for the bell schedule. Students will have all 7 periods every day, Monday through Friday, and there are 2 lunch blocks. Either students will start lunch at 11:31 or they'll have their lunch at 11:56, and that's on Monday, Tuesdays for Cohort A and Thursday, Friday for Cohort B. On Wednesday, Remote Learning Day, all 7 blocks meet, but they are shortened periods, meeting only for 20 minutes each, and students are required to log on to Google Classroom in order to meet with their teacher during each of those periods. And though, even though it looks like it's a shortened day, when students complete meeting with all 7 periods, all of their teachers, the rest of the day from 10 until 2:10, students are working independently, getting homework done, studying, doing work that's been posted online. For students who have severe airborne allergy, their parents must contact our head nurse, Donna Fabrizio, by emailing her at dfabrizio@bridge-rain.org before school starts. When students enter the classroom, they are expected to sanitize their desktops. Students and staff are required to wear a mask throughout the day. There are 3 mask breaks every day, blocks 3, block 5, which is the lunch block, and block 6. At the teacher's discretion, the students will either do their mask break with all of them going outside with the teacher, or half of the students going into the hallway, spreading out, not disturbing other classes. Or number 3, if there are very few students in the class, they can spread out in the classroom and have their mask break right there in the classroom.
Since today is very nice out and it's block 6, let's go outside for a mask break.
Sounds good. It's 6th block.
We should have a mask break.
Since we're so close together, maybe half of us should go into the hallway.
That's a really good idea, too.
We'll go.
If students are in class and want to drink water, they can either raise their mask to drink water, or a second way to do it is they could lower their mask to drink water.
I think it's time for a water break.
Definitely.
Refreshing.
When using the water fountain, students must bring a water bottle to school, and they can fill up the water bottle at the water fountain. No one is permitted to drink directly from the fountain. Students are expected to wash their hands throughout the day and use the sanitation stations in every classroom. There's a gallon pump hand sanitizer in every room. Also, students can use the bathroom during class time. The bathrooms are closed during passing time. The library is not available during study halls this year. It is not available before nor after school to students. Teachers may bring their classes to the library. Every teacher has an extra help day. It is at least once per week. So this year we have staggered dismissal times. 1:55 p.m. senior drivers can leave. At 2 p.m., those who take the school bus can leave. At 2:05 p.m., junior drivers are dismissed. And at 2:10 p.m., the rest of the students are then dismissed. The 2 p.m. time for bus riders is a specific contract time that we have with the bus company. So that 2 p.m. time is non-negotiable. Now, in case someone wonders the hypothetical, if you are a senior who drives to school, you get to leave at 1:55 p.m., but your younger sibling or a friend of yours who's a freshman or a sophomore or junior, they want to get a ride with you, Can they be dismissed sooner? The answer to that is no. They have to honor their dismissal time, and the senior driver would just have to wait in the car until those whom she or he is driving come on out at their appointed dismissal time.
Oh, it's 1:55, class. Seniors, you are dismissed. It's 2:00. Buses, you're dismissed. Oh, class, it's 2:05. Juniors, you're dismissed. Okay, class, it's 2:10. Any remaining freshmen or sophomores, you are dismissed.
Good evening. My name is Donna Fabrizio, school nurse here at Bridgewater Rainham Regional High School. I want to thank you so much for being here tonight. I realize that these are some trying times that we are dealing with right now with COVID-19. And although the school will look a lot different this year and the health office will look a lot different, the one thing that does remain the same is our commitment and our dedication to keeping our students healthy and safe. So here at Bridgewater Rainham, we have two registered nurses on staff. Myself and Mary Jane Aruda, Eileen Bailey, our health aide, Claire Grennan, who is our district nurse leader, is housed here up at the high school, and Dr. Gagne is our school physician. Services that we provide include first aid, illness, treating injury, health screenings, suicide prevention screenings, SBIRT, which is a substance use prevention screening. Those are all being waived this year due to COVID. We are also monitoring immunization compliance, assist with medication management, and we will also be monitoring COVID and staying in touch with our Board of Health nurse. Parents should be screening their children daily for the following prior to coming to school. However, if students do present to school with any of these symptoms, they will be isolated and referred to their pediatrician. They must test negative or isolate before returning to school. This is per DESE guidelines. Things that we can do to prevent COVID-19 include wearing a mask, physical distancing, which is a critical tool in preventing the spread of COVID-19, hand hygiene, and staying home when ill. So parents and guardians, we will be asking for your help in reinforcing with your children the 3 W's. Wear a mask, wash your hands, watch your distance. This is the best way to protect everyone. Symptoms of COVID-19 include fever, chills or shaking chills, cough, difficulty breathing or shortness of breath, sore throat, loss of taste or smell, headache, muscle aches or body aches, nausea, vomiting or diarrhea, fatigue, and nasal congestion. Please complete your child's emergency forms as soon as possible. Information will be coming out on this and it will be done through the portal again this year. So please make sure to verify and update all emergency contacts. If your child presents with COVID-like symptoms, they will be placed in isolation and will need to be picked up immediately. Please ensure a contact can be reached at any given time. And also please just make your nurse aware if your child does have any medical issues such as diabetes, life-threatening allergies, anything like that, and we will develop a care plan to support your students' medical needs while here at school. Other important tips include staying informed, educate yourself from reliable sources, make sure that you are staying up to date with wellness visits and immunizations with your pediatrician, and contact your child's school nurse with any questions or concerns. I want to thank you again, and I want you to know how committed we are to supporting your child's health and education. We hope that you have found this information shared tonight informative and helpful as we plan for re-entry. Our goal is to support one another, treat each other well, and most importantly, keep everyone healthy and safe. Thank you and have a good night.
My best advice is to be yourself, but be open to new friendships and new experiences. Find a club or sport you like and get involved.
My advice for incoming students this year, and in particular freshmen, is to ask the hard question, or any question at all. Because I guarantee you, if you have a question, 20 other kids have that same exact question. And don't be afraid to talk to your teachers. Whether you have a question, comment, or concern about the class, they'll be more than willing to help.
Get involved in something. Here at BR, there are several things that a new student could do, ranging from playing a sport to acting in drama club, playing in the band, or even getting involved in competitive robotics and competing with teams across the country and the world. And if there isn't something here that entertained you, the good chance you'd find other people willing to help you start a club that you would be interested in, and you can get the most out of your high school experience.
My advice to other students is to get involved. I feel like a lot of my best friends and closest friends I've met through doing sports and extracurriculars, because it really just brings you closer to people that have similar interests as you and people that are different from you, that you may not have the same like school strengths, but you're similar in other aspects. And I feel like that's where I've met a lot of my closest friends and people I never otherwise would have met. So I really think getting involved in extracurriculars and sports is really important throughout high school, just so you can kind of widen your perspective and your personality and just gain a lot of different strengths. And we obviously don't know how they're really gonna look this year, but if we have them, I really think it's important to get involved.
My advice is to take advantage of all the extracurricular activities that BR has to offer, whether that being sports or clubs. Just being involved with your high school will not only benefit you, but your whole community.
Hello, my name is Tom Bresnahan, and I'm one of the three high school principals at Bridgewater Random Regional High School. In this video, I will discuss student attendance and communication. I will begin by explaining our expectations for student attendance. For all three learning platforms, which includes fully remote, hybrid, and face-to-face, student attendance will be taken daily by all teachers. Students are expected to do their very best in attending all scheduled classes. With regards to tardiness, students are expected to be on time in school as well as their scheduled classes. Because parents will be asked to help screen their children in the mornings before school, and our implementation of one-way hallways to help improve physical distancing, both the high school administrative team and teachers will exercise some flexibility on a case-by-case basis this school year when deciding if a student is tardy to school or individual classes. To help students and staff with the new one-way hallways, we have increased passing time between classes from 4 to 5 minutes. At the high school level, student attendance is tied to receiving credit for courses. We are aware of the challenges this school year will bring in relationship to COVID, and the administration will exercise some flexibility when dealing with student attendance as it relates to earning credit. The same procedures are in place for parents to provide appropriate documentation per our student handbook when a student is absent. Parents' guardians are still required to notify the school in the morning if their child is not attending that day. By law, the school is still responsible for notifying parents, guardians, if their child is excessively absent from school, as defined by Mass General Law, Chapter 76. The same dismissal procedures will be used as last year, which are listed in the student handbook. Parents must provide students a dismissal note in the morning, and they will need to drop that note off to the main office when they arrive. The note will need to include the time of dismissal, a phone number, the date, the reason, and how they will be dismissed, picked up at school, or having permission to walk or drive themselves. Also, we need to know who is dismissing them. Anyone showing up at school in person to dismiss a student will need to show proper identification and be on our contact list with permission to dismiss. If a parent guardian wants a student to be dismissed, someone other than a previously identified contact, they would need to include that in their dismissal note along with a contact number. The school will verify this when calling home. In summary, student attendance has been proven to be an essential part of student growth and responsibility, as well as having a direct impact on their learning. We look forward to working with each family this year to ensure students meet their full potential. In the second half of this video, we're going to discuss communication. We believe effective and ongoing communication is vital to student success. Our goal is to have a strong school, parent, guardian, and community collaboration. There undoubtedly will be some issues this year that will arise, which is why it is so important to try and start with the immediate source first. If an issue occurs in a classroom, it can almost always be rectified by speaking to the teacher first, and then the student's assigned assistant principal afterwards, if needed. It is imperative to provide all stakeholders with ongoing information and keep an open line for dialogue. Most issues can be resolved through a phone call, email, Google Meeting, or a face-to-face meeting when possible. We urge all parents, guardians, and students to check daily announcements on our Bridgewater Random Regional High School website. The link is included in the slide. Several platforms to improve two-way communication will be used. This may include the parent portal, Twitter, Facebook, emails, voicemail, phone calls, Google Meetings, and Connect Ed calls, which will be made after 7 p.m. unless there's an emergency or time-sensitive information. We look forward to working with all families to help make this as fun and productive of a school year as possible. Our doors are always open to the Bridgewater Random Regional community. On behalf of the entire Bridgewater Random Regional High School administrative team, we hope everybody has a great year.
Hi there, I'm Yolanda Beach, one of the assistant principals here at BR, and I welcome you to new student orientation. So glad you guys could join us this evening. And there are a few things that I want to talk to you guys about just really briefly. So one is about the cell phone policy, also community service. And then also I want to let you know about clubs and activities as well. And really just want you to be successful. So let's start with cell phones and what the cell phone policy is. So with our cell phone policy, the key thing that all students must remember that we're doing differently from last year is when you come into your classes, every class, all 7 periods, you must put your cell phones away. So in your bag, your backpack, be sure you put your phones away in your bags. Now, if you're using your cell phone for academic reasons and you have the teacher's permission, no problem. Yes, you can then use your cell phone in class with your teacher's permission because you're doing something academic related and you have the teacher's permission. Now, keep in mind as well that when you have a directed study, which we sometimes call a study hall, you can use your phone so long as you're doing something that's academically related. And then you can also have one earbud in. So if you have, you know, your earbuds, because maybe you want to listen to a video that the teacher has posted, so that's academically related, that is fine. Just keep in mind only one earbud in, not both, because we want to be sure you can hear if the teacher gives you instructions or if somebody says something. It's really important that you be able to hear them. So again, only one earbud in. Now, with the cell phone policy, please be sure that you honor the cell phone policy. Now, what happens if you don't? There are consequences that range from your parents being contacted and an administrator having you turn your cell phone into the main office and then contacting your parents regarding picking up your cell phones, all the way up to suspension. So there's a range. So you just want to be sure that you always keep your phone away so that you don't have to deal with your parents getting a call and you getting an after-school detention and then you being assigned a longer after-school detention if it happens again, all the way up to being suspended. So we're not going to have problems. Just be sure you keep your cell phones away and in your bags. So that's the first thing. The next thing I want to talk to you guys about is community service. So community service is a graduation requirement here at BR. The requirement is that you complete 15 community service hours per school year. But this year, because of COVID-19, we're making an adjustment. So we are waiving community service for this year. So that means that we do not expect you to do community service for this school year. Now, let's say you've done some community service and you're like, oh wait, I did something this summer. I was able to, you know, help out at this organization. No problem. If you want to turn those hours in, you can, because we keep community service forms right here in the main office. Just come to the main office, you get a form, you fill it out. The person who you did service for, they fill out their portion of it and they sign it. And then finally, your parents, your guardians, they also need to sign the form as well. Then you turn the phone in into the main office. So just hand that form in once it's done. So that's for community service. And it's such a great way in order to get some experience, you know, working, serving, learning a new skill. But that's for the future, since again, community service is waived for this coming school year. Now, the next thing that I want to tell you about is clubs and activities. Just want to let you know that more information is to come because we're making some adjustments because of the COVID-19 impact. More information is coming up because we typically offer dozens and dozens of clubs and activities that students can be involved in. It's a great way to get to know other students. But again, more information is coming up about that. Finally, I really want you guys to be successful here at BR. So the key thing that I want you to know is that you have resources. So whether that be you're having trouble in classes, whether that be you're having trouble with another student, there's something that's interfering with your success here, please know that we're here for you. Please know that guidance, your counselors, they are a resource for you. So you can talk to them if things are bothering you, if you have questions. Also know that your administrators, your assistant principals, we are here for you. There are three of us. So let me tell you which of us has which part of the alphabet so that you know who your assistant principal is. So Mr. Ringett, he works with students whose last names begin with the letter A through the letter F. F like Frank. Mr. Bresnahan, he works with students whose last names begin with the letter G through N-E. And then me, I work with the last part of the alphabet with students whose last names begin with the letter N-G through Z. And please know that we can work with any students in the building, but in terms of the students that are assigned to us, who we do the most work with, it is those students that are in our part of the alphabet. If something happens and your assistant principal isn't here, of course, we are here for you. We're here for all of our students. So just know that you can be successful here. If you have questions, if you're stressed, if you're wondering about things, just ask. Advocate for yourself and say something, because when you say something, then we know and we can help you. Finally, your teachers. Your teachers are a resource for you. If you're struggling in the class, if there are issues either within the room with other students or with the subject, with the homework, ask. Just know that we want you to do well. So glad you guys are here at BR. Like, we can't welcome you enough. This is now your school, your second home. Welcome to BR. Have a great year.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Hallgren, one of the counselors here at the high school, and I'm going to share some information with you about what it is that we do in the high school guidance office. So give me just a minute and I will get the presentation on the screen. Welcome to the guidance department. So when you are called to the guidance office, you are not in trouble. In high school, your counselor is your advocate. We are working with you to help you reach your goals and to support you through the ups and downs that may come through these next 4 years. We have 6 counselors in the guidance suite and an adjustment counselor. Mrs. Dooley is the department head. Mr. Barber, Mrs. Carreau, myself, Mrs. Hallgren, Mrs. Redfern, Mrs. Smith, and Mrs. Suarez is the adjustment counselor. You will have the same counselor all 4 years, and this is great because we get to know you really well. And the better we know each other, the better we can help you navigate high school and plan for the future. Remember, no parent wants you living in their basement, so you will need a plan. What is it we do? With academics, we monitor your schedule and your grades. So we make sure that you're taking all the classes that you need to be prepared for graduation, but also what you need when you leave high school. We do a lot of work on advocacy. We are your advocates, but we help you develop self-advocacy skills so that you can address issues with teachers, peers, or your parents as they come up. And goal setting. We do a lot of work around goal setting because as we're planning for the future, you're setting those goals to help you get there. So whether it's college you're looking at, a career, the military, we're setting goals from freshman year on. That work begins. So we'll explore what you want to do and help figure out how do we help you get there. Social emotional support, because stuff happens. And we know that this year better than any. Everybody needs support at different times, and that's what we're there for. So along with the conflict resolution and advocacy skills that we work with kids on, stress management is a big one. Stress and anxiety are going to creep up on everybody at some time, and it's okay to need a little extra support. So we work with everybody to give you the tools that you need to get through those rough patches. And when things get really hard and maybe you need a little bit more, we have referrals that we can give to you to help get you that added support if that time ever comes. The student counselor relationship is really a partnership. We work together and communication is key. The more we talk and the more we get to know you, the better things will be and the easier for us to help you all the way through high school. So a few ways that we'll work with you and communicate with you is one through email. Every student will have a BR Google email, and that's going to be great because you can just shoot an email off to your counselor if you've got a quick question, or maybe you want to set up a meeting. And that's a great way to reach us and for us to be able to reach you. So we want to get in that habit early on. Also, we use Twitter. We are at BR Guidance. And start following us right away. We post a lot of upcoming events that are going to happen at the school and a lot of dates and deadlines and things that you just don't want to miss out on. Office visits. So those will look a little different this year. We've always had kids able to pop into our office, and there will be some changes, but we still want you to know that you can come down and see us and not just when we call you down. So you can do that through email. Let us know, hey, I need to see you, and we'll get you down there to see us. Also, we'll be using Google Classroom. So that's going to be a new tool we're going to use, and we'll get more information to you once we start the school year about how we'll be using that. So here is a list of all of the counselor emails. You will have your assigned counselor the first day of school. And remember, all 4 years you have us, so by then you should really know this email address. So hang on to this so that once you have that counselor, you know who to reach out to. So welcome to BR. We look forward to working with you for the next 4 years.
Hi there, my name is Mr. Bosworth, and I'm a Spanish teacher here at the high school, and I would like to welcome you to your first year here at BR. I recommend that you ask as many questions as you possibly can, to be flexible and to stay positive, and to try to communicate with your teacher and your peers as much as you can. Welcome and good luck.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Short, and I teach 9th and 11th grade English here at BR. Welcome to our school. I'm so glad that you're here. This is a great place to be every day, and we're really happy to have you. My advice is to always bring your pen or your pencil to English class and come to class ready to work and write and think. Stay safe, stay healthy, and I'm sure I'll see some of you soon.
Hello, BR. I'm Mr. Hayhurst, and on behalf of the English department here at the high school, we want to welcome our new students and our returning students back to school. We are excited to get back to learning, to teaching, and to all the good stuff we have in store for this year. Good luck, and we will see you soon.
Hey guys, it's Mrs. Hickey. I'm one of the physical education teachers here at the high school, and I'm in our gym right now, waiting for you to come back. Come on back. We miss you. We love you. We can't wait to see you, and we can't wait to meet all the new incoming freshmen. So my tip for you is when you're at home doing your remote learning, you can't get energy unless you expend energy. So get up and move. Take those movement breaks. Get the circulation going. And when we see you in person, we're gonna do just that together. But I can't wait to see you guys. This has been long overdue. Hope you're doing well. I'm excited about this. You should be too.
Hi everybody, I'm Mrs. Kelleher. I just wanted to take this opportunity to welcome you to BR and just let you know how lucky you are to become a member of this wonderful school community. Some advice I have to you would be to get involved, join some clubs and activities. That's a great way to meet other students. I think this is a great message too, just be kind to one another. Ask, because everyone here is very helpful if you have any questions, and have a great year. Be positive.
My name is Mrs. Cooley, and I'm one of the math teachers here, and I just wanted to welcome you to our school and our team. Remember, strength doesn't come from the things that we can do. It comes from overcoming things that we once thought we couldn't do. So this year, set goals for yourself, try new things, put yourself out there, and ask lots of questions. And remember that your teachers are here for you, we support you, and we care about you. Wishing you a wonderful year.
I'm Mrs. Lydon. I'm one of the PE wellness teachers here at BR. I'm so looking forward to getting back to school with everyone and meeting you all. Many of you I had at Williams, and I'm super excited to see your names on my roster. My advice for incoming freshmen is to get ready to just have time fly before your eyes. So enjoy every minute. High school goes by so fast. Get involved in as many things as you can, because you never know who has similar interests than you that you wouldn't necessarily meet through your classes. So join clubs, sports, extracurricular activities, and just get involved. It goes by really fast, and there's so many awesome people in our school that you have yet to meet. And come to all your teachers with any problems you have. We are all here for you. I can't wait to meet you all.
Hi, new students. Welcome to BR. I want to just give you some quick advice. Maybe just be you, be a good person, and have a good time. This is a great place. You're going to love it. So we look forward to meeting you. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Mr. Lucia. I'm a science teacher here at BR.
I'd like to welcome you to our school. I'm excited to meet you, and I look forward to learning together. My best advice to you is to come here every day with a good attitude and an open mind, and I guarantee you will find something here that makes you excited to come to school every day.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to BR. My name is Mrs. Fauché, and I look forward to meeting you. I have a couple of words of advice for you. Number one, when in doubt, just ask an adult. We'll be standing in the hallways those first few days. Don't panic, don't worry. Just stop and ask us. We're more than happy to help you get where you need to go. My second bit of advice is don't worry about being late those first few days. We know you're new, we know you're nervous. Between that and the new one-way hallways, you're going to be late, and that's okay. We'll help you through it. Again, have a great rest of the summer, and we will see you soon, and have a great year.
Hi everyone, I'm Mrs. Redfern, and I'm one of the guidance counselors here at BR. My advice to you is to remember you're starting new, a brand new chapter. Believe in yourself, and remember, you have a lot of people here rooting for you and supporting you. I can't wait to meet you all.
Hi, this is Robert Runget, assistant principal at Bridgewater Raynham Regional High School. I'm here to talk to you about social media responsibility in and outside the school and things you might want to be aware of. Now, when I'm looking at social media, Facebook, Twitter, InstaChat, whatever it might be, I'm always thinking that if there's a post that really gets me going, really just boils me up on the inside, my spidey sense starts to kick up a little bit. And ultimately, I realize that if I respond in a knee-jerk reaction, it's a trap. Now, back in 2017, a federal judge was dealing with a free speech issue with students posting on an Instagram account. Other students were invited to follow it, and the student that created it created racist and derogatory messages that targeted other students and school personnel. Well, when that happens, and it happens inside the school, there are consequences ahead. Now, the students who created the account were expelled, and those posted were suspended. Their records were not expunged, and had to follow them through job applications and college applications. So, just be mindful. Consequences may be just ahead. Now, different types of social media responsibility, subtweeting, cyberbullying, derogatory opinions about people in general or specific people, racy pictures of anyone. I mean, after all, what is the worst that will happen? So let's talk about some subtweets. So we've got some subtweets going on. You know, we talk about them. Some of them are really funny. Some of them give us that old Kanye versus Taylor thing, and then they put it in songs. And then some of them are just about, you know, not wanting to say something directly to somebody else. So ultimately, that is what a subtweet is. Do yourself a favor. If you can say it to somebody, say it to somebody. If you can't say it to somebody, learn how to. Cyberbullying. Okay, so cyberbullying, this is a criminal offense. It's a repeated online attack on an individual. And please, if you know of it, report it before it gets worse. I've just put some cyberbullying examples up there in the top corner. I encourage you to read them. Get familiar with them. All right, posting derogatory remarks. So when you express hostility and criticism towards a person, a group, or an object, you can actually be sued for defamation. That can get expensive. A lot of people make out with $50,000 plus rewards for spreading rumors or lies about these people that causes them to have a lack of character in other people's views. So, if you are going to post something about somebody again, don't post any hate speech. It's just not worth it. All right, here we go. This is a sensitive issue. Let's just say you have a significant other, or a boyfriend, or a girlfriend, or whatever you might want to call them. Imagine you're super close, and you're thinking, okay, I'm gonna share a picture with that person. Well, just remember, the person you're sharing that picture with, they might also be sharing it with their friends, and they might just be having a good laugh about it. So be careful what you send as far as pictures. And this is potentially criminal. There are age differences that you must be aware of when it comes to this type of stuff. So ultimately, you want to ask yourself, how do I look online? Here's a couple of scenarios. So you walk in, you say, what do you mean you're firing me? I'm allowed to voice my opinion about the company and its customers. I have free speech. And your boss might tell you yes, but you can't defame the company or members of the company or its customers or give away inside information. You're fired. Again, don't post any hate speech. It's just not a good way. How come my scholarship or acceptance got rescinded? It was just a MySpace or Facebook, InstaChat, TikTok, or even a Tinder post. Didn't offend anybody. Again, you might only run in certain circles, so maybe it did. So just do yourself a favor, be careful what you post, and don't post any hate speech. Here's a good one. You're just drug testing me the other day. Why are you doing it again? I'm allowed to post about my private life. Boss might tell you, yes, you are. Because we can't allow you to operate that forklift or drive that van or operate any machine on this campus, if you're under the influence of any drugs and or alcohol, we are going to test you or you're fired. So do yourself a favor. Don't post about drugs and alcohol use. It's just not that cool. Ultimately, you might snap something that's offensive and think better of it, and within 20 seconds, you were like, yes, got rid of it. No harm, no foul. I guarantee you, somebody already has a copy of it, and they might even be willing to use it against you. So just be mindful before you hit that send button. So in a recap, do yourself a favor. Don't post about drugs and alcohol and all the partying and all of that stuff. Just don't do it. It's not cool. Don't post hate speech. Again, it's not a good look. It could run you into some hot water. So, ultimately, don't post hate speech. Again, trying to hammer this message home. Hopefully I did so. Because in the end, the big question is, how do you look online? Thank you. Have a great day.
Hello everybody, my name's Eric Delisle. I am the food service director here at the Bridgewater-Rainham Regional School District. I have been for 14 years now. The cafeteria manager at the high school, her name is Carol Curry. She's been around for a long time too. We're looking forward to an interesting school year and we're getting ready for you. You can see our email address, the brfoodservice@bridge-rain.org. That's what most people use. If they have a question, I'll get to it as soon as I can and get back to you. That's probably the best way to get to it, get out to us. There's the website. Answer a ton of your questions. If you want to surf around there for a couple of minutes, you might find what you need. It's attached to the BR website, so go to BR website, bridge-rain.org, family resources, cafeteria. That's the way to kind of see what's going on. All right, welcome to the new school year.
Good evening, my name is Annalise Caldwell. I am a board member of Bridging Lives. Tonight I am here with Sarah Pettit, Alicia Caldera, Julia Mitten, and Shannon Matthew. I'm going to pass it off to Sarah to talk about who we are and what we do.
In this youth coalition, we work with many different people. Tonight, I am just going to name a few who we are in constant contact with. These are people whose names you will hear all the time. From Brockton Area Prevention Collaborative, Amanda Sandoval and Gabby Ferruccio are our leaders who give us ideas and projects to be working on throughout the year, as well as statistics and any useful information we may need throughout the year. From Bridgewater-Rainham Regional School District, we are always in contact with Ms. Watson, Mr. Ringette, Mrs. Fabrizio, one of our school nurses here at BR, and Mrs. O'Brien, the advisor of the peer leaders.
Most of our activities we participate in are either run through the state or through the Brockton Area Prevention Collaborative. We participate in monthly coalition meetings, Sticker Shock, Kickbutts Day, and Youth Power Summit, as well as present to neighboring schools in the district and towns. The whole point in these activities is to promote substance use prevention, whether it be alcohol, drugs, vaping, or gambling.
There are specific personality traits that the Bridging Lives Board look for in any new recruits or inquiries. Most important, we look for someone who is committed and open to new things. As a member of this group, participants must be hardworking and open to new ideas and challenges. Working in this ever-changing environment, members must be able to adapt and respond to new obstacles or requests by mentors. While working with students who ask for help, it is important to have empathy and compassion. Some other preferred traits are being willing to help and educate others, and constantly being able to stay motivated and involved. Importantly, if you do not have any of these traits, that is completely acceptable, and there are other things you can do in this club. We will not turn you away, but instead welcome you and help you find something that is fit for your strength.
This year, we will be looking into both marijuana and alcohol. Throughout the COVID-19 pandemic, we have seen a drastic surge in numbers of people drinking, including underage people trying to cope with stress and anxiety. We have also seen a drastic surge in numbers from use of marijuana. In 2018, only 8% of college students admitted to even trying it once, and unfortunately, in 2019, there was a surge up to 43% of college students admitting to using or trying marijuana. Both the use of marijuana and alcohol will continue to rise, especially this year with this pandemic. We hope that with our work, we will help those numbers not rise nearly as much as some other towns or cities may rise.
This year, we have made an application for anyone interested in joining. This application is easy and quick. Please don't let this shy you away from joining. We are only asking for this to be completed so that we can see past commitments you have made and your availability on Tuesdays, as well as contact information so we can contact you. If you would like to fill this out, you can join our Google Classroom using the code V3BD2Y2 and go to the classwork section of the classroom and go to application.
If you are a student with any questions or interested in joining, please contact either Shannon or Sarah with the emails listed below. If you are a parent or if you are not using a bridge-rain.org email, please contact Mrs. O'Brien with the email listed. We will try to answer as soon as possible. On behalf of Bridging Lives, thank you for listening tonight, and we hope to hear from many of you soon.
Welcome to Bridgewater Rainham Regional High School. Thanks a lot for coming along for a tour of the building. Here's our main entrance that we're about to head inside. Hey, let's go. Visitors will enter through this door, so if it's parents or others who are coming, this is the entrance. Here is the intercom so that we can buzz you in. All visitors must check in and must have a driver's license or a state ID. And now here is the main lobby of the high school. And to the right is the main office. Let's head inside. To the left is our reception waiting area, so parents and other visitors can wait here if they have a scheduled appointment. Our principals are here. Many of our secretaries are here. If a student is late, they check in here. If a student has to be dismissed early, they bring the note here at the start of the day. Or if they were absent the day before, they bring the note here. Here are the community service forms. Blank ones are here. Once they're filled out, you return them here. All right, back out to the main lobby. There's the auditorium. There's the cafeteria. We'll see that a little more later. And now, guidance. Hey, let's head inside. Remember, the main office is just to the right. Guidance is here on the left. And here is our waiting area for visitors if you have an appointment scheduled with one of the counselors. And our receptionist secretary is right here able to assist. Our counselors have their offices here, and here's a great place to come to talk to your counselor, to ask about the classes you can take, that you should take, to ask about your GPA, grade point average, to ask about colleges and applications, even the ASVAB, if you're not sure about what career may be best for you. If you want to know about credits, because you get credits when you pass classes, Guidance is the place. They can answer those questions for you. And now we're back out into the main lobby. Let's head further down. Main office is on the right, Guidance is on the left. We're in the A wing, and we're headed to the nurse's office. We're going to take a right here. And here is the nurse's office. So if a student isn't feeling well, or if a student needs to take medication during the school day, the medication remains here in the nurse's office and students come here. If a student needs to be dismissed because they're not feeling well, the nurses are the ones to make the calls home. So again, we're coming out of A-Wing back to the lobby area. There's the auditorium straight ahead, and here is the cafeteria. And as you go to the district's main webpage, bridge-rain.org, and click on Parents, you'll find information about the cafeteria, so you can find out how much the lunches are, about your child's lunch account, so that you can regularly add money to their account for them to buy lunch, for them to buy snacks. There's also more information there as well under Parents, like the free and reduced lunch form, and other really helpful information for parents, the academic calendar, and lots of other good things. So again, we're in the cafeteria, and we're going to head straight ahead, heading down C wing. So if you have gym, it'll say C on your schedule because the schedules have the room numbers, the teacher name, and the subject. So when it says C, that means you're headed for the gym. And here is where you will have your PE classes, right here in the gymnasium. We also have our sporting events here, our TJ Square event here, their competition, and also the pep rally also takes place right here in the gym. All right, we're heading back out the gym, and let's continue further down this hallway, going away from the cafeteria. We'll take a look to the left here. And yes, the locker rooms are just down this way. And now to the right, let's head this way. So now we're behind the cafeteria. This is the D wing corridor. Let's take a look at the music rooms. So for those courses where students are playing an instrument, or if the instrument is their voice and it is chorus, it takes place in these rooms. All right, let's head back out to the hallway. And this is a pretty unique room. This is our robotics workshop, room D134, so TJ Square, here's where the magic happens, where they are building robots. TJ Square Club is an amazing group, award-winning, so many volunteers, so many great things come forth. Headed back out to the rest of the D-Wing, where we have our computer lab and lots of interesting classes that students get to take. Now, headed back down D-Wing, continuing on. And then D becomes the B-Wing, so it's both the D, and as you continue to walk, there are the B classes. So a class may say B-102, for example. That means first floor. That means B-Wing. Let's head back out to the main lobby area, where to the right is the main entrance and the Cinderella stairs. Just going to take a spin around just so you can get the lay of the land. And again, main office and guidance to the left. But let's head down this hallway. We're going to head towards this juncture where we have the F, G, and H wing. To the right is the elevator. Students must have a pass to take the elevator. To the right, here is H wing. First floor, where we have chemistry and physics classes. To the left is our main staircase, so you can get to the second and third floor classes. And here is where we connect the F wing and the G wing, but to the left is the restroom for students. We have one on each floor in that same location. So take a look, there's a computer lab on the left, the door is open. And straight ahead is the G wing where we have our social studies classes. And to the left is the F wing where we have our math classes. And again, there's the elevator. And we're gonna head upstairs, going up this main staircase, again, that connects all three floors. Now we're on the second floor. You have the elevator. Once again, straight ahead is the H wing. So the same wings are on each floor. Biology classes are on this second floor H wing. Straight ahead is F and G. And as we continue, remember the restrooms, left-hand side, we're on the second floor, but they're in the same location on the first floor and on the third floor. So straight ahead, you have the G wing. English classes are down this way. To the left is the F wing. And we have a combination of some English classes, math, history classes down this wing. Again, on the second floor, that's one of our computer labs. Let's take a quick look inside. So that room number is E218. So the computer labs have a room number of an E when they're at this location in the hallway. To the left, F wing, let's head on down. So if let's say your class says it's room F202, then you'll be going to the second floor F wing, and there's your class. We have student lockers in these hallways, and we're just gonna head straight down. Please pardon our appearances. We're preparing to close down for the year and get things cleaned up and ready for a brand fresh new year. Heading up the stairs, we're going to the third floor, still in the F wing. So we're at the end of the hallway. This is the foreign language wing. And we're gonna head right down this hallway back to that connecting juncture. And you'll see in the classrooms that you'll see this hanging blue pouch, and those are our cell phone holders that we have in every classroom. All right, let's continue forward down F wing, going to that connecting juncture. To the right is our hydration station. So you can look to each floor to find a hydration station. To the left is G wing once again, but we're on the third floor. No high school students are permitted down G wing. That is for BMS only. So now, let's head on down. The restroom is to the right. And straight ahead, we have the elevator to the left, and we have the foreign language lab in that corner. That once again is H-wing, where we have earth science and astronomy classes. That's the BMS office there. So here's the foreign language computer lab. Lots of fun, interesting activities. Students get to record themselves. They get to go to fun websites and practice grammar and vocabulary and all sorts of activities. All right, we're heading down the stairs now, going back to the second floor and to the right. This is the main staircase. Straight ahead, H-wing. There's the elevator. And let's head back towards the front of the building. So to the left will be the lecture hall. Straight ahead is the library. Again, we're on the second floor. And to the right, we're going to be heading down to the art wing. There are those Cinderella stairs that lead back down to the first floor. But first, let's take a look around, get a sense of the lay of the land. Just so you can get your bearings here on the second floor. Now let's head into the lecture hall. And here in the lecture hall is a great place where when we have guest speakers, our students come here with their teachers and we have the guest speaker here. So special presentations are done here. Exams are taken here when there are large sections, for example, like AP exams. Let's head down the B wing corridor. So this is the art wing where you will find the art studio and the ceramics studio as well. So remember, we're breaking down for the summer, so you're going to see things in boxes and packing that has begun and work being taken down. But we just wanted to give you a sense of the lay of the land, so as you look at your schedules, you'll have a sense of where to go and how to find your classes. So again, second floor, B wing. We're in the art studio, and this room connects across to the ceramic studio. So let's head on across and take a look to see here in the ceramic studio, which is B206. You can come on in and we can see, looking around, looking at the equipment. We'll even get to see a flash of some student work. Let's head back out into the hallway. So second floor, B wing. We have some student artwork that's still posted. And we're going to head straight back down this hallway, going back towards the lecture hall. That's straight ahead, Cinderella staircase to the right, library to the right. That's the auditorium that's to the right as well. That's the second floor level. There's the cafeteria down below, first floor. All right, now heading into the library. So here's a place where students can come after school so that they can get schoolwork done. And also during their study hall during the school day, but students must get passes in advance the morning of when they would like to go to the library during their study hall or the day before. And their study hall teacher has to sign it before they go to the library. If you have a class that's in room A212, 2 being second floor, and on the second floor, that's where the A wing is. It's a part of the library. Let's head down the Cinderella staircase. Oh, glass slippers are optional. There's the auditorium. We're spinning around. Here's the main lobby. There is the school store. You can get lots of great paraphernalia, t-shirts, sweatpants, blankets. Again, auditorium is to the right, cafeteria is to the right. To the left was guidance and the main office. Let's head on out the door. Thank you so much for taking this tour with us. We really hope that it was helpful just to get a sense of the layout of the building. That's the gym that's straight ahead on the left. That's the cafeteria. Straight ahead is the main entrance. We are BR. Thanks for joining us today. One team, one family.